Hello, I'm Gabriel Neagu. Welcome to DataBytes channel. In this video, we'll talk about data integration in Azure Synapse Analytics. Azure Synapse Analytics is a fully integrated analytics solution offering orchestration with Data Factory, compute with dedicated SQL pools, on-demand SQL pools, and Apache Spark pools, storage with Data Lake Gen 2, and visualization with Power BI, all in Azure Synapse Studio, a development environment with management, monitoring, and security tightly integrated. In this video, we'll talk about the orchestration part of Azure Synapse Analytics, more precisely about Data Factory. Let's jump into Azure portal and explore the Data Factory component. Log into Microsoft Azure portal by using your account. If you don't have an account, you can sign up for a new one and create a new subscription. Once in Azure portal, create a Synapse workspace. If you don't know how to create a Synapse workspace, please follow the video Azure Synapse Analytics overview. And then once the Azure Synapse workspace is created, click on the resource and then go to Open Synapse Studio and open the workspace. Once in Synapse Analytics workspace, expand the left section and go to the Integrate. The Integrate tab is the orchestration part of Azure Synapse Analytics. Here is the place where we'll create the pipelines and the data flows. Click on plus, click on pipeline, and let's create our first pipeline, which will copy data between a CSV file located in into Azure blob. We'll copy that data into a data warehouse, a SQL dedicated pool in Azure Synapse Analytics. So give the pipeline a name, pipeline demo, and then go to move and transform, drag and drop copy data. Give it a name, copy CSV to EDW. You can give a description. And as a source, we need to select the Azure Blob Storage CSV file. Let's create a new source data set. Click on New, Azure Blob Storage. Select Azure Blob Storage. Click on Continue button. And then our file, it's a delimited text CSV file, so select delimited text, click on continue. Then you can give it a name, delimited text demo. Linked service, we create a new linked service which will connect to our Azure Blob Storage, Azure Blob Storage demo, let's say. And then select your Azure subscription, storage account name. I already have a storage account name called DLEDW. And then test connection before creating to see if everything is okay, connection is successful, and click on create button. So this will create a new linked service. Once this new linked service has been created, we will select the file path. We'll select the container where the CSV file is located. Click on this icon and then go to FSEW. This is just a folder, a container in Azure Blob Storage. And the file we need, it's customer CSV. I want to show you where this customer CSV file is located. So if you go to your Azure portal, you see in the storage account here, if you click in storage account, go to containers, then the container called FS files share EDW. And then as you can see, we have a customer CSV file in a blob located here. Okay, so now we created this delimited text link, click OK. And this is the source data set, the CSV file located in a blob storage. Of course, we can see what it's in that CSV file. We have two ways we can see it even here. But we use Azure Synapse Analytics for this. We go to data, we go to linked, and here we have the our Azure Data Lake Storage 2. We expand this section, we expand our Data Lake blob, and here in this container FSW we find our customer CSV table. Click right on customer CSV table and then we have new SQL script. Select top 100 rows and use the built-in SQL pool to query this CSV table. In this case it's top 100 rows, but we don't have, I think we have only 4 rows there, and click run. The script will run, and as you can see, this is the data in our CSV file. We have a number of columns and only 4 rows or data. Now let's go back to our pipeline, and I think we are done with the source. Let's click on sync section, and in this sync section we will specify the destination of our data rows, which in our case is SQL dedicated a pool, a data warehouse. Let's see if our data warehouse is open. It's running. As we go to manage, we go to SQL pools, and SQLW, the dedicated SQL pool, it's paused. Let's start this. Click on the SQL pool. If you don't know how to create a dedicated SQL pool, please follow the video above. And we will need to start this SQL pool. For this, we need to go to manage, to SQL pools, and click on this button, resume. And as you can see, resuming SQL EDW dedicated SQL pool. Let's wait for this to be resumed. Shouldn't be long, but in the meantime we return to our integrate tab in our pipeline demo, and click on copy data, and in a sync section let's define the destination for the CSV data. In a sync data set, let's create a new sync data set. In this case will be our SQL dedicated pool. So let's search in this, it's Azure Synapse Analytics, Azure Synapse dedicated SQL pool. Select this one, click on continue, and let's name it SQL pool table. It will be a table in this SQL dedicated pool. Then click on SQL pool, and this is the already created SQL EDW dedicated SQL pool table file. It's failed because at this moment I think it's still resuming. The dedicated SQL pool is still resuming. So let's cancel this and discard changes and go to the manage and see it's still resuming. I will stop the video until it's done. So successfully resume SQL EDW dedicated SQL pool. So let's go back to our integrate section, to our copy CSV to EDW pipeline, to sync, and then let's try to create again a sync data set. Click on new, then select SQL Azure Synapse Analytics Synapse dedicated SQL pool. Click on continue. Let's give it a name. Select SQL pool. This one, you can see now it's a green circle with a tick box. Click on this. Load table name will load the available tables in that SQL pool. As you can see, we have a table name dim customer. Select this table and click OK. SQL pool table demo sync data set has been created successfully. Now, as a copy method, we'll use Polybase. We have an option to auto create table, but in our case, we already have the table created in our destination. We can use a pre-copy script, and in this case, we use the script to truncate the contain of the destination table. we do this in order to not duplicate the values in that table. So let's type the SQL command truncate table DBO dim customer, and we leave this unchanged. Then we move forward and click on mapping and click on import schemas. This will be the mapping between the source and the destination. Source, the CSV file, destination, a table in a data warehouse. And these are the source column, 1, 2, 3, 4, and the destination, ID, first name, last name. So we need to check if the number of column corresponds with the destination columns. And we come back to our script when we query the CSV file, and column 1 its ID, column 2 first name, column 3 last name, and column 8 is the postcode. So back to our pipeline, instead of column 4 here, we put column 8. Now before moving forward, we know that in the CSV file, the first row, it's the name of the column. So we need to skip this first row. And for this reason, we need to go to source and skip line count 1. Okay, so we are good with the source, sync is good, mapping is good. Next, settings. We need to enable staging for the polybase copying because the polybase needs a staging location. So click on enable staging, select your storage account. We have already Azure Blob storage, and I created a storage container, a storage folder staging. So we select this, hit OK. And now we are ready to publish the pipeline. Click on publish all, and the pipeline will be published. And after the pipeline is published, let's check the destination table to make sure it's empty. So we go to data, we go to SQLDW dedicated pool, and we go to dim customer. Let's query this new SQL script, select 100 rows. And as you can see, it's nothing into the data warehouse at this moment. Let's go to the pipeline and run the pipeline by clicking on debug. The pipeline is being started and it's running. Let's click on refresh button. As you can see, it's queued at this moment. It's in progress and will finish soon. And once it's complete, we'll go to our destination, in our case, SQL data warehouse, dedicated pool, and we'll check if the data is there. Let's do a check again the source. We have 4 rows with this data, and the target is nothing at this moment. The pipeline succeeded. Let's check the destination, go to script and run. As you can see, the data has been populated. If we run again the pipeline, go and debug again, the data will be truncated in the destination table and will be copied again from the CSV file. It's running right now in progress. I rerun the pipeline. Of course, we can trigger these pipelines. In this case, we triggered manually, succeeded, but we can trigger them at certain times or in a sequence. In our case, we did it manually. Let's check the data in the data warehouse. And as you can see, the data is not duplicated. So we're just creating and run a pipeline, copying the data from an CSV file located in Azure Data Lake into the SQL Data Warehouse in Azure Synapse Analytics. I highly encourage you to go to a home knowledge center, browse gallery, pipelines, and explore the samples of pipelines and see what you can do with Azure Data Factory in Azure Synapse Analytics. Now, before closing up, there are some differences between Azure Synapse Analytics versus Azure Data Factory. As you can see in Microsoft Azure, we have Data Factory service, which it's different than Azure Data Factory. I mean, it's not different. It's the same underlying, is the same Azure Data Factory, but there are some slight differences. You can go on Microsoft Docs and see those differences. For example, in Synapse Analytics, you cannot use SSIS integration runtimes. You cannot have SSIS package activity. There are small differences, but basically, underneath the engine in integrate section is the same Azure Data Factory. We've just scratched the surface on what we can do with data integration in Azure Synapse Analytics. Of course, we can do more than copying individual files from Azure Data Lake into a data warehouse. A typical business case use scenario is copying the data from on-premises business systems like CRMs, ERPs, billing systems, HR systems, production manufacturing systems, project management systems into a data warehouse for analytics. We can even create business-oriented data marts. We can do that by ingesting data from these diverse and multiple sources, having at our disposal more than 90 built-in connectors. For example, we can use Amazon Redshift, Google BigQuery, HDFS, Oracle Exadata, Teradata, or even software as a service systems like Salesforce, Marketo, and ServiceNow. We can connect to both relational and non-relational data. We can consolidate this data from multiple data sources, and we can transform the data according with business rules. With data integration in Azure Synapse Analytics, we construct ETL and ELT processes which copy, clean, transform, and store data at scale. Practically, we take the operational data and transform it into data analytics. Operational data is the data used in day-to-day business activities. The ultimate goal is to provide business with quality data analytics, which are used for taking informed decisions, translate data into actions, and improve business performance. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to DataBytes channel. Thank you for watching.